For the trend now, I used to just consider higher high, higher low, but as you know, if you've been following the mentorship, this is clearly not enough. This is the second part of me explaining how my journal is set up. So if you didn't, make sure to watch the first part where I'll talk a little bit about my background in neural network and data science, and also go over the trade we're currently reviewing, which returned up to 5%. For the trend now, I used to just consider higher high, higher low, but as you know, if you've been following the mentorship, this is clearly not enough to consider a trend. You can check out the advanced market structure of ICT. So once I watched this video, I knew clearly that this was not useful. I would need to update it. So I'm not filling this section anymore. I need to update it, but for now I'm not filling it. And anyway, based on the, I think I filled up around 150 trades using this trade section, and they were not very saying anything. So this is not too important for me. Then this is a great section with different things. So here we can see some concepts which were introduced by ICT and other things that I just wanted out of curiosity to know. So one example is, do we see the trade also happening on US 500 or not? So what I found out after filling it multiple times is usually when you see it on US 100, it also usually come on US 500. So I just stopped filling those two anyway. Here, if we have an equal or 830 relation. What I wanted to do by checking on that is, do we see a relation, something useful between the New York Open and 830 Open? So my hypothesis, let me know if ICT talked about that, but this is something I just wanted to check out for myself. Say the New York Open is lower than the 830 Open. Can we just keep on buying so we know the direction is up, you know? Let's check the day before. Midnight open would be here. Then the 8:30 open would be around here. So around the same level. Is it useful for us? Does it say something to us? But for the today's trade, New York open was lower than the 8:30 open. So the hypothesis would be that we just keep on buying. I don't know if it's true or not. I'm just trying different things. And in this case, since I sold, it was against this concept. So against the midnight and 8:30 relation. If we go back, was it in the 9:30 open direction? So you know at 9:30 we have a big push. Was it in the same direction? So in this case at 9:30, we just went straight up. So do we need to continue buying or do we need to go against the 9:30 open? So in this case, since it went up, and I sold, it was against the 9:30 open. Was it with the London session direction or against it? If we check the London session, which starts around 2 and then finishes around 5, so it went up, went down a little bit, then continued to went up after 5 a.m. I think ICT says that it's from 2 to 5, but clearly it went up. So what I did here, I went against the London direction. Against. Is it inside or outside the range? So the range I'm talking about is, if you look at the ICT mentorship, he's saying that we need to take this level from here to here, for example. Then you need to double it, and then you need to trade inside this range, right? Like this. So since this is inside the range, we need to write that it is inside. So this stops us from taking a trade which went much too far. Let me find an example. So say we take this range here. So if I was going to take a trade around this level, this is clearly outside this range right there. So I would need to write outside. And if you want more details about what I'm talking about in this video, you can just check out the ICT mentorship. So in this case, it was inside the range. Did we have a close of the lower high or higher low? So what I wanted to find out is that, did we have just a wick and then came back up for taking out this low, or was it a great close? And in this case, clearly we closed below this low, because ICT clearly said that even if it's just a wick going down, it's still considered a break of structure. But I wanted to know, is there a significance if it's with a closed candle? So in this case, it was a closed with the close. And then finally, is it against or with the 830 concept? You usually want to sell above the 830 and then buy below the 830 level. So in this case, since it was, that's a big coincidence, but exactly at the 830 level, but we went a little bit higher, I would say that it was with the 830 concept. So I'm selling above the 830 level. The time the setup formed, so we said that it formed at this point here at 9:50. So I need to fill up everything. Liquidity grab. So you know that it was yesterday's high. So out of curiosity, if you want to see the other, it can be a gap. It can be the midnight open. It can be a 15 minute fair value gap. Usually I don't use those two, the order block. I'm just going with the stop hunt. Was it in the Asian session? Was it just a yesterday level? In this case, this is yesterday's high. The time. 2 days low, an old daily higher low, and then 2 days or older higher low, not on the daily. So it would be, for example, the day before yesterday, but on the 1 hour. And then finally, did it reject an untouched fair value gap after the displacement? So what I wanted to find out with that is sometimes, you know, in this case, it is the case. So you can see here the small fair value gap. So what will happen sometimes is we will have the displacement just to go fill up a fair value gap that was lower, and then we will go straight back up. So this is something important for me to know if it has an impact on my trades. So in this case, it did fill the fair value gap, went back up, but when it went back up, it was just to fill up this other fair value gap before going back down. So here it was, it did reject an untouched fair value gap. So here it did go back to the stop hunt. So what I'm trying to say here is something that I'm just testing out myself, is that did the fair value gap form below or above the level that was taking out? Because at the beginning, I would see yesterday's high being taken out, then a fair value gap forming on top, and I would still take it. But clearly it's more significant if we see the level being taken out, then we go back to the level that was stop hunted, and then we form the fair value gap below. And in this case, it was indeed below. So if we go back here, it was back to the stop hunt. Is it against yesterday high or low taking out? So that's just something for me that I wanted to test out myself. I don't think ICT talks about that, or maybe it does, let me know. So what you would think is usually if we take out yesterday's high, we should just continue back down because a lot of liquidity was taking out. So let's say in this case, yesterday's high was taking out. You would only need to sell, technically. This is a hypothesis. I'm not saying it's true or not. You would only want to sell. So if I'm taking a buy and the yesterday's high was taking out, it is against yesterday's high being taken out. But in this case, it is with, so it's not against. I hope it was clear. I'm not too sure about this one, but let me know in the comment. I can go above that once again. Does it have a 2 minute fair value gap? In this case, it did have a 2 minute fair value gap. And this is different from forming a setup in the 2 minute, like I filled right there. Because to have a setup on the 2 minute, we need a break of low. But what I'm trying to say here, let's say the break of low was on the 1 minute. Then we have a 2 minute fair value gap, but we don't see any lows on the 2 minute. This is why I wrote that here. And then finally, is it with or against the midnight concept? And then the midnight concept I'm talking about is the same as the 830 concept. Is overall, you want to sell above the New York midnight open, which is the case here. So it would be yes. Here you can put your screenshots. But you still don't know how useful this journal is, or even how to use it. So check out this video to see how I managed to increase my win rate using this exact journal.